Cut it out! I'm just trying to live my life! No one taught me about carbs!
Well, this is why you want soft luggage, because I'm really stuck. Huh? Yeah? Yeah.
Hold on!
Yeah!
Don't lift it yet!
See? Can you see it? There you go. See how that foot got cut under there? Now, if that was hard luggage, that could have been a lot worse. The sand's nice and soft here, at least. But that's why you want to wear coyote bags. Great, thanks, Harold.
Sure thing.
Fresh cut from the Rally Raid CB500Expo Ride 11-day, 3,000-mile event. This is the way I should have packed. I've had a few days to collect my thoughts, receive some of the feedback, the great feedback we've got on Facebook and YouTube so far, and would like to share some of this information with you. Some of the stuff I've learned hanging out with Harold and Jenny for 11 days. Had I to do it all over again, I would repack my bag like this. Let's check out what the difference is. One of the best pieces of feedback I got was from Gary Apple on Facebook. He said, "What about the bag itself? I missed the whole point. The whole point of this exercise, the whole point of Harold picking up the distributorship for Rally Raid and the CB500X, one of the benefits he's hoping to achieve is to sell more bags. Because this bike design is specifically designed to work with his bags. These solo racks, I think they're RRP444, are the perfectly lightweight, elegant solution to this coyote bag, which is the perfect solution for this size of bike. And for the tank bag, the Diablo bag is just the right scale and size for the CB500X. And that's all you need. As Jenny says, you can ride indefinitely with this setup. Let's take a look at what's inside the bag, and more importantly, what I should have left behind on this trip, what I didn't need.
With the single giant loop bag, jacket, sandals, you still have plenty of room to roam about the bike. Let's weigh this up too and see what we're down to on weight.
One of the greatest testimonials I heard out at Outdoor Expo, I wished I'd captured on film, was from a very experienced adventure rider regarding his coyote bag and his great basin bag. He said it's like the perfectly compliant pillion passenger is always in perfect position and never wiggles around. Now, of course, when you're working with these bags, if you need to get something out during the day of the ride, you're going to have to kind of take everything apart to get into it. That's maybe the one disadvantage. So you want to pack it up right at the beginning of the day and hopefully not have to get into it till the end of the day. Things that you might want to access during the day, throw it up here. Be sure to neatly tidy up all your spare straps or they're going to get frayed. At the end of the day, just undo the two forward straps, slide the whole thing off. And these are the solo racks that the brackets slide onto. And of course, these hooks are adjustable right in here so you can get the perfect tension on your coyote bag. Unzip your Diablo bag and take that with you too. Carry 212 pounds with the pack and the jacket. 187 pounds for me and my clothes. So that's only 25 pounds of gear, including the bag itself. So that's good. Keep it around 30 pounds. Again, 30 pounds, about two notches or two full rotations on the preload spring on the shock will take care of that amount of cargo weight. So let's take a look here at the stuff I should have left behind. I didn't need for this ride. I didn't need the second inner tube. You only need one inner tube, one large inner tube that'll fit both wheels. I didn't need the second bag of emergency food. I've just got one bag of emergency food. I certainly didn't need the fishing rod. If you're going riding with Jenny Morgan, you're going to be riding all day. You ain't got time for recreating and fishing.
The Giant benchmark maps, yeah, they were always a pain to, and very heavy to carry around. Just get your stuff squared away in your GPS so that you don't have to rely on these maps. These should be left home for route construction and not necessarily needed on the route itself.
Instead, use the benchmark paper state maps, much smaller and lighter.
The wrappers to both the tent and the sleeping bag go away, and I'll show you how I got them stuffed into the coyote bag, just free stuffed. The second bag of jet boil fuel. I got the jet boil, but you only need one can. That's good for 28 burns. If you run out, just get another can in town. The camping stool, yeah, it's still very handy, but not absolutely necessary. The silky big boy. There's some, there's a great clip I'll have to share with you about Jenny and the silky big boy saw. It means something completely different in another world. So that means I didn't need to carry this the whole dry bag with me. Now, the dry bag is a very convenient solution and a very watertight solution to all your sleeping gear. But if you run it this way, you don't need it. And that means you don't need the rock straps to strap all that down. So I would have left all this stuff at home and just gone with this. But the key to doing it this way is to having your tools set up properly. And let's check in with Jenny Morgan and see what's under Jenny's seat. She's got a very elegant tool packing solution that fits entirely underneath the CB500 seat with minimal modification.
Okay, so this trip I decided rather than put my tools in my luggage, which if I wanted to take the luggage off and go trail riding, which we're going to do at Expo, I didn't want to have to, you know, have them in a backpack. I try to fit them under the seat of the Honda. And it's got all these various little compartments, which actually all I've had to do is cut the top off of this little bit. And this allows the Motion Pro packet to fit under there, under the seat.
Mm-hmm.
And basically I've taken a leaf out of Dave Lomax from Adventure Specs Handbook. He reckons all you need to repair your bike on the trail is the Motion Pro metric trail tool, which is this little selection of tools, and a Leatherman. And the Leatherman I use is quite a basic one. It just has pliers and knives and screwdrivers and a bottle opener, all important bottle opener.
Yes.
So this tool basically has a series of, it's like one of these sort of multi-bicycle tools, but more heavy duty. It comes apart like this. You have 14 mil socket, 8 millimeter socket. It goes together like this to create a T-handle. You've got a 12 millimeter socket on there. Another bottle opener, always handy. And then it has an adapter, where is it, here, that allows you to fit either quarter inch or half inch, 3/8 inch sockets.
Mm-hmm.
So the quarter, this fits in the end of here, so you can use it as a quarter inch driver for quarter inch sockets. If you put it the other way around, you can use 3/8. And I've supplemented it. I mean, obviously, this is the core tool, but if you've got any specific size nuts and stuff on the bike, I have a 17 millimeter socket, which works for our engine guard bolts on the front here.
Mm-hmm.
I have a 19 millimeter socket, which works on the opposite side of the rear axle.
Right.
And then under the seat.
Yeah, there they are.
Here we go. So the Rally Raid, 24 millimeter for the rear axle, 17 millimeter for the front.
Yep.
And the spoke wrench, which is quite handy. We've included as well.
Oh, okay. I was always wondering what the heck that is. All right, spoke wrench.
I bought my own spoke wrench as well, but then I always forgot that John included the spoke wrench on here. And then again, I've supplemented it with 10, 12, 14 and 17 mil. These are Honda, you can buy these off eBay. These are Honda toolkit spanners, genuine Honda parts. Mm-hmm. They're about $5 each, they're not expensive. And what that means is if you've got an Allen bolt in one hand, you can hold the back of a nut with a wrench. Because obviously this really works as a single tool.
Right, so you need something to back it up.
Yeah, but most modern motorcycles use captive nuts. You know, you don't often have a nut on the back of a bolt. The bolt goes into something.
Yep.
This is my test run to prove if Dave Lomax's theory is correct, that all you need is effectively a Leatherman and this
Motion
thing,
Pro,
and you can adjust anything on your bike, fix anything on your bike. Basically, it's to get you off the trail. You're not going to change an engine with this necessarily, but it'll get you to a place where you can change it.
What else is in there?
Well, in the
cabin. What are these?
Oh, in here. Okay. So what else I've got under the seat? That fits literally. All this fits inside the pouch as well, so mm-hmm. it fits in that space. I've got a cycle pump, air compressor. Mm-hmm. These are warrantied. I think they have a lifetime warranty. They have a very good warranty backup. If it ever fails, they'll repair it, replace it for you.
And it's electric, runs off
That's
the
an
battery.
Electric, yeah. Mm-hmm. And I have a little power feed just here. So I can run the compressor off there, or I use that as a battery tender mm-hmm. when the bike's not being used, which isn't very often. So that lives in there. The handbook is under there. It's always handy as mm-hmm. a reference point. In here, this is effectively my puncture kit. This is a bead buddy, Motion Pro bead buddy, a valve stem puller. It can be pretty tricky getting the valve through a tire. So this is to do that, and a patch kit. And I also have...
Now, where's your tire irons?
Right. Hold on one moment. Pause.
Okay. And Harold, do you know what the hell these things are?
Yeah, those are rim protectors. So you're not barking up your rims.
Brilliant.
When you fix your flat. Just got some quick steel in here.
Yeah.
A little electrical tape, it looks like. Mm-hmm. Some webbing.
Is that like a tow rope?
Strap. Mm-hmm.
Some tape.
Duct tape.
Yep. Universal fix-all, the craftsman's friend.
Not sure what we've got here. Jenny can fill in the blanks here.
Yeah, right. So, and start again.
Yeah.
Right, so my one concession that is in my luggage, because uh-huh. these won't fit under the
yeah.
seat, is my tire irons. Now, these are, again, Motion Pro tools. Not sponsored by Motion Pro, but they do make some very good stuff.
Mm-hmm.
These are great. They're a tire spoon, nice round end, hopefully shouldn't pinch a tube. And on the other end, you've got a various number of large wrenches. There's a 22, 24, and 27, which are typical. Yamaha's use 22, Honda's tend to use 24, 27 is for KTMs. So even if I'm out on the trail with somebody else, I've normally got a wheel nut wrench for those guys. That also comes with a little insert that allows you to use a 3/8 drive. And because they're, you know, kind of 8-10 inches long, you can get some good leverage mm-hmm. on there. So they're good.
And it's lightweight aluminum alloy
totally,
too, right?
T6 yeah. aluminum. They're not cheap. They're about $30 each.
Yeah.
But they're really good, super light, mm-hmm. great quality. Inside this bag, I've also got a whole bunch of zip ties as well, which yep. are always useful. And then I bought this. I don't know how good it is. I really hope I don't need to test it on this trip. This is, again, another Motion Pro thing. It looks like a little spade for digging digging your toilet out in the trail.
Oh, come on, yeah.
or digging.
Is that where you bury the bodies?
Yeah,
no?
That's where you bury. They call it their bead breaker. Basically, okay. It's like a little plastic wedge with an end on there. You can whack it with a hammer if you have one, or the end of your boot, you mm-hmm. know, anything just to whack. You can put this in between the rim of the wheel rim and the bead. Whack it with a rock or anything like mm-hmm. that. They say something that weighs a couple of pounds mm-hmm. ought to pop the bead all the way around. It makes it much easier. So I bought one of those just to see, but I hope I never have to use it. Similarly, these are my Tart rim shields. Again, this is like a Motion Pro
to protect the gold rims.
Exactly. You know,
the bling. Yeah.
That's totally why I bought them.
Okay.
But I've seen them in use. I've used them and they actually work really well. Basically, you put them on like that mm-hmm. and then you can lever, you know, you can really wrench on that tire, and particularly if you're, you know, not in a workshop scenario mm-hmm. with nice big tire irons, you know, having something like that is perhaps, you know, it's going to save them from being damaged. But yeah, I must admit those and this are a little bit of an indulgence. They're not yes. what I would call essential. They're something I bought for this trip this year.
Mm-hmm.
In here is a length of webbing strap, which I can use as a
toe strap. Yeah.
Yeah. And in here, I've just, the only other things I've supplemented from my main trail, what I call my rally toolkit that I take with me, is this is a DRC spoke spanner, and it has a spoke wrench, and it has different heads that you can swap out depending on which bikes you're with. So currently it's got the size for this bike and my XR400 at
mm-hmm.
home. And then a 13 mil wrench. The only reason I've included this is when you fit the Rally Raid kit, one of the things they recommend is that you replace the 12 millimeter lock nut on the chain adjusters with
yeah.
a nylock, because
okay.
they can
and is this
vibrate
a nylock?
Loose. This is a nylock.
Okay.
And because the nylocks are 13 millimeters, not 12, uh-huh. obviously the Honda spanner doesn't
right.
work, so you need to use a 13.
Cover that.
And similarly, we also supply a pair of nylock nuts for the clamps, the two bolts that hold the headlight support frame onto the headstock, mm-hmm. because again, those are just a couple of dome nuts. We found in, you know, extended use, they can potentially come loose. You know, I mean, you could put thread locker on them and they might be all right, but we just think that, you know, the Nylock is a mm-hmm. belt and braces. So that's my only other concession to Dave Lomax's.
Brilliant. All right, so what's in?
And then
in...
this quick steel.
Yep.
There's a roll of electrical insulation tape.
Do you do anything for the chain, like an extra master link or anything?
No, yeah. I mean, again, it's a balance point. The chain, when they come standard on the bike, it does not have a split link in it. It's a riveted chain.
Right.
I do have, and I did take with me last time, the Motion Pro T6, their chain breaker mm-hmm. tool. It's a lovely tool. Never needed it, so I've left it at home this time. I mean, yeah, you could be really unlucky and break a chain, but they're a pretty heavy duty 520 chain. And mm-hmm. I think, you know, again, it's one of those things that...
The chances of.
Yeah. And I mean, people have fixed chains with a pair of pliers and pounded them with rocks. Mm-hmm. If needs must, mm-hmm. you could do that. But no, I haven't felt that, you know, in 13,000 miles last year, the chain needed adjusting, but it never caused any issues. So, and then in here, there's also another little thing that's quite handy for punctures. I'm trying to essentially cover every base, should we get one, and hopefully never have to use them. This is a little bottle of just soapy, washing up liquid and water, and this helps. it really helps to get the tire beads back
to get
on
the
when
beads,
putting the tire back on again. You know, and if you want to do the dishes when you're camping, you've got
something there too.
But this is the nice thing about the Honda. I mean, actually, if you look at it, there's plenty of space in these little side pots.
Yeah,
you
know,
people might think these body panels are a little superficial. Oh, there's some spare nuts and bolts, M6 and M8 nuts, washers, different length bolts, for example. Yeah.
And so, that doesn't rattle around in there too much?
No, yep. I mean, they're nicely wedged in there.
Yep.
And as I say, having them, you know, everything under the seat means the tools and the repair, the get you home, the budget repairs, mm-hmm. as I call it, are all on the bike all the time, mm-hmm. you know. And I think that you can kind of leave the seat on there and forget about it. And the only concession I would have to do when we go trail riding is put those levers in my Camelback and take those with me.
Yep.
The rest of it stays on the bike the whole time.
Brilliant. There it is. What's under Jenny's seat? And we'll get you home. That's a brilliant...
Let's hope so.
Yeah. Tool setup. Because, as you know, the tool setup on the stock Honda consists of what?
A fuse puller
and a 5 mil Allen wrench.
Here it is.
And we don't even know what it's for.
There it is. There's the fuse puller.
That's right. Geologist cabin. Death Valley. Okay, now let's see what's in the bag. Okay, by stuffing this tent and the sleeping bag in here with just free form, you can allow it to conform to the bag more. Now, one of the complaints Jenny had about her camping is freezing to death in her sleeping bag. Well, she had a very lightweight summer sleeping bag. The Cat's Meow from North Face is a 20 degree rated bag, is a great lightweight solution. And if you can get that bag inside of a nice, cozy one-man tent with a tarp on it, this is the REI Passage 1, you can really create a cozy, warm environment down to about, a little bit below freezing, 28 degrees. Add a few hot rocks to the bottom of your bag and you'll make it through the night. The Big Agnes Air Core insulated mattress, absolute necessity. Keep you insulated from terra firma. One inner tube just kind of horseshoed around in the shape of the bag. One additional giant tire iron. Just one emergency meal. And here's all the clothes. Basically, the laundry, you need a second shirt, second pair of underwear, just throw them away as you go along, a warm pair of thermals for sleeping in. Where's the other thermals? As far as clothes go for the trip, again, I'm still just riding and living all day in my Carhartt shorts. Got the Climb Mojave pants over the top of that, and this, and a t-shirt and one spare shirt, and then some warm thermals for sleeping at night. And that's it for clothes. And that's it for extra shoes, the sandals.
jet boil stove with a human gear spork with the fuel in it, a full can of fuel, good for 28 burns. That'll last you 2 weeks of riding. Stocking knit cap, keeping warm around the camp. Even a camp pillow, that's quite a nice additional feature. Luxury item, I'd say. Here you go, the nice dry pair of socks.
One issue of prophylactics, three lipsticks, three pair of nylon stockings. Shoot, a fella could have a pretty good weekend in Vegas with old Lance.
How do we do it? And that takes care of everything in the bag. And that's all you really need. Here they are, the thermal bottoms. So when you get to camp, you'll be in a nice, dry, warm, cozy place. And if you're not riding in technical terrain and you want to more than double your load carrying capability, the Giant Loop Siskiyou panniers are specifically designed for the Rally Raid CB500X. Of course, they're universally acceptable on a whole bunch of motorcycles. And for that design, you'll need to replace the solo racks with the Rally Raid luggage racks. And these luggage racks would replace the solo racks right about there. You could even add rotopacks and or additional cargo storage to the inside of these racks, as there's plenty of room. This is a super convenient packing solution. Check out the 1,000 Miles of Northern California Twisty video series for a complete review of this setup. Along with all this, I'm running a lightweight summer jacket that breathes air and keeps you cool and gives you protection. And of course, the OGO flight vest, where I got access to water all day long. My spot tracker with the Giant Loop Packer tracker. And miscellaneous first aid, emergency water drinking straw, and some small tools in here. But keep this bag light, and maybe you can put a tire iron or two in these big pouches, but try to keep those empty for sandwiches and stuff at the end of the day. With the Giant Loop tracker packer on the spot locator, you're able to keep the spot tracker on your body instead of mounted somewhere on your bike, because I think in the event of an incident, you're going to be separated from your bike and not in a position to get back to the bike to activate the spot tracker. I think it's safer bet to keep it on your body with the tracker packer. And when we got to the grocery store, Harold whipped out this tiny little Chico sack from out of his bag here, and then proceeded to get a shopping cart and damn near fill up a shopping cart full of groceries, and was able to bring that whole bag of groceries home to camp with this Chico bag strapped through the compression strap here, and the groceries all laying right here. The Rally Raid CB500 Expo Ride, what a great learning experience. This packing business is just a constant state of refinement. Overpacked is underprepared. Lack of prior planning leads to piss poor performance. Go light, go fast, go far with Giant Loop.
Jenny Morgan testing out the virtues of the silky saw.
The silky big boy. You see, in my world, that's a whole different toy. But your version's quite good, too.
Yeah.
I think if you shopped online for a silky big boy, you could end up with a package you didn't quite expect.
Oh, oh, now I'm slowly getting it. Well, it's a bit cold this morning, and we've heard a lot about it from Jenny, who would, oh yeah, let's see what you got here. She would just about be as happy in a hotel room, but... Oh, come on! We love camping. And a teepee in Bryce Park doesn't get any better than this. It's just a little cold.
July or August.